time for the match game, Hollywood Squares. Our win from after match, Jamie Farr. From the hotel, Heidi Bohe. From another world, Linda Dano. McLean Stevenson. Arsenio Hall. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bauman.
It just fun.
Okay. It came from Las Vegas. That's right.
That's scary.
It really is something, though, that light wall, isn't it? Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You were splendid to show up here today, and so were you.
Thank you.
Oh, listen, I don't have my breath spritzer here, but I'd like to welcome the new kid on the block. Oh, thank you very much.
Heidi, you better use it.
Me too. Wrong side. There you go, me too.
All right. Welcome.
Thank you.
No thanks at all, really? You gave it the office?
No, I just was hoping to get lucky at the cast party, that's what I thought.
You're all splendid to be here, and I love each and every one of you, but we've got to get underway here. So let's have a brisk round of applause for our two players over here. We have Amy Lynch and Claudette Lindsay. Welcome to you. Now, Amy, we want to find out about you, please.
Well, Gene, I'm from Santa Monica, California.
Santa Monica, a wonderful place to live.
Yes, I love it. And I'm a freelance copywriter. I'm married. My husband and I love to travel. And my hobbies are music and photography.
Okay, Amy, nice to have you with us. Now, Claudette, let's hear from you, please.
Well, I'm a happily married housewife. I have a daughter, Christy.
You say you're happily married.
I am.
You are?
Oh, yes.
Oh, all right.
I have a little girl, Christy Sue, who's going to be 4 in July. I am living right now in South Orange County, but I'm originally from Sweetwater, Texas. I enjoy dancing, singing, music, and I've been watching Match Game for 11 years.
Good for you, Claudette. All right, let's begin now. We'll play 3 rounds here in the Match Game. The winner will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Amy won the toss. We'll ask her to go first.
B, please.
All right, Amy, here's what it says. The warden said...
Oh, wait, man.
That condemned man is the dullest guy I ever met. As his last request, he asked for a blank.
John Bauman and I match profiles.
Yeah, that's right.
Don't we, John? Turn sideways, John.
I agree.
Yeah. We'll block out the set.
We got more nose.
We
more nose on today's show. All right, everybody ready?
Sure.
Here we go, Amy. The warden said that condemned man is the dullest guy I ever met. As his last request, he asked for a blank.
A nap.
A nap.
A what? A
Not
nap?
Not bad.
A nap?
What is your last request? Warden, I'd like to take a little nap. I think it's quite amusing. Amy, she's a writer.
About a 12-year nap.
Yeah. What did you got?
Oh, am I first there?
You say
oh,
it. Say you hold yes. it up right here.
Okay.
And then
yes.
say it at
see,
the same
I
time.
I have never done this.
Yes.
All right. I'm
All right.
sure I'm going to get a terrible
right
response
here, like
for it.
Go
okay.
Ahead.
I said a blank wall.
You said that, huh?
Yes.
That's terrible. You've never done this show. I know you've never done this show before.
Put your
oh, come
nose
on.
In
the
front
answer
of that
wasn't
part.
That good.
What do you mean?
What did you get for us?
This was his last request.
Yes.
I put prunes.
Oh,
better delay it, right?
Yes. All right, Warden, what do you say,
okay,
Heidi?
Okay, I got real original here. I said book.
Book is good. That's good because that could delay it by the time you read it. You don't like book? I think book is quite good. What do you say, John?
Illiterate crowd.
Right.
I'm not too wild about this answer. I kind of like to put my nose in front of it. But she's a writer, so I said a copy of the Saturday Review.
Well, that's okay.
Yes,
I like that.
In the hopes of matching book.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or magazine.
Yeah. Now, yeah. Linda, you've been around this track many times.
Oh. And I'm equally as bad each time.
Really?
Yeah. I sort of took from everyone and put comic book.
A comic book. That's all right.
I try. But, you know.
Arsenio, you were the first one finished, weren't you?
I'm frightened of this crowd.
Yeah.
Really? No, I was going to put video cassette of Family Feud, but that was too much to write. I decided to put book.
A book. All right.
A book.
Amy,
I should have put comic book.
I thought yours was quite amusing and very well done. Claudette, you ready for yours? Here it is. You know how every year the swallows return to Capistrano?
No.
No, no. Do they?
No, they fly. Here we go. Well, Nerdocrumbesia, for those begin, that's our mythical sleazy country. Nerdocrumbesia is so sleazy, every year the blanks return to Nerdocrumbesia. Got all that, Claudette?
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to check up on you, Jamie.
You better do it fast.
Ready, Arsenio?
Yes.
Here we go, Claudette. You know about the swallows and Capistrano and all that. Well, Nerdocrumbesia is so sleazy, every year the blanks return to Nerdocrumbesia.
Cockroaches.
Cockroaches is okay. They like that one. Are they going to like yours?
Oh, am I first again?
Yeah, you're first every time.
You and I, honey, are really sleazy because I said cockroaches.
All right. They're cheering the cockroaches.
Yeah, I thought she'd stick with the bird genre.
Oh, right. The bird genre.
Genre.
Genre, of course.
Yeah. Anyway, I said vultures.
Vultures, that's good. I like that one. Cultures is okay.
Well, I stayed away from the animals. I said vagrants.
The vagrants. I think that's quite good.
Well,
flying
I don't care
vagrants.
What you think of it. It amuses the heck out of me.
It's my first
The flying
time.
Vagrants return every year to Nerdocrumbesia.
That's right.
I like it very much. But we do have to explain to you, Claudette, that, you know, when it's indicated that it's a bird, you should stick with a flying creature. So I said cockroaches.
Right. Yeah. Super, Claudette.
Seemed like a thing to do, huh?
What do you got for us?
I really like my answer, too, because I thought flies, birds, they have wings.
Right.
So flies.
Flies. That's right.
That's a good answer.
A dirty insect.
No?
I don't know. See, this is a strange crowd. Usually, if you have a pretty girl on, she can say, toe jam, and they, But this crowd, they're fooling Heidi, so I'm frightened to death. I said rats.
Rats is good. You got two, you got none, you're ahead. We'll go to round two. Right after we do this for you.
This summer, Buzzer turns the wee hours into
the wee hours!
Anarchy!
Buzzer's Nightcap. Tonight, starting at 2. All night on Buzzer.
We're ready. Round two coming up. Claudette, you're ahead. You have to go first. You want B? All right, here it is.
All right, now, Linda, thank you.
Say, did you hear that dumb Donald is in the hospital?
No. It's nothing serious, I hope.
Yeah, he's in the hospital.
How dumb is he?
Well, I tell you.
Which hospital?
How hospital is he is what you mean. Here.
Sorry.
Here's a mosquito landed on his forehead, and he tried to kill it with a blink.
Yeah, a lot of bug
flesh. Dumb Don was in the hospital. A mosquito landed on his forehead, and he tried to kill it with a blank. It's a very easy one. Two good answers that I can think of. Two really terrific answers. We're waiting, Linda.
That's an accomplishment.
Thank you.
All right. So, Claudette, Dumb Donald's in the hospital. A mosquito landed on his forehead, and he tried to kill it with a blank.
A hammer.
Hammer is a good one. All right, you matched in the previous round, so you don't play this one.
Oh, but I had such a good answer. Did I get to show it anyway?
Would you like to show it? All right, let him show it.
Bedpan. Charles Seaman.
That would have been funny. That would be
see,
a funny.
No one would have said Ben.
I know. That's why I wrote
because,
it.
See, he tried to kill the mosquito before he got into the hospital. See, you're assuming the mosquito landed on his forehead while he was in the hospital.
You need that while you check in with
him. All right.
That's right, back on the prunes
that's
question.
Why yours was a dumb answer and this was a good one. Gun.
Gun is good. Good. I think it's good. You think it's good?
I think it's good, but mine is better. I'm catching on. I said sledgehammer.
Sledgehammer. When I said there are two good, pretty good answers, gun and hammer were the two that I had in mind. Now, what do you say?
Well, I thought it was in the hospital,
what?
Too.
What?
Oh, really? You didn't do that?
Boo.
Oh, wait. Holy mackerel.
I object to that. No. A hammer is a hammer. Whether it's a sledgehammer, a claw hammer,
a hammer
is a... If it was Mike Hammer, what difference does it make?
Right. All right, now wait a minute. The question is, if we match it, are you willing to give her the money?
No.
No.
Give her the money.
No match. No, he won't.
Yes, he will.
No, I won't.
No. Are you employed?
No.
He won't give her the money. What do you say?
Well, I thought it was in the hospital, too. So I would have matched Jamie, but I cheat all the time. So I said hammer.
All right. What do you got for us?
I don't know if she's married, but I'm the guy she's been cheating with. I got hammer.
Are you married?
Yes.
All right.
It's all right. Okay.
So, Claudette, you picked up a couple of more. And, Amy, we have this one for you. Let's see how you do. Rodney Dangerfield said. You do. Do you do Rodney Dangerfield? You do Rodney Dangerfield. Does anybody
I didn't even do Match Game.
You do Rodney Dangerfield.
I'm just kidding. I don't do anybody.
I just do the body language. I don't do
all it. Right. Well, I'll do the words. You do the body language.
Get over here. Come over here.
He said, Rodney Dangerfield said one day.
Oh, I'll tell you.
He said,
I tell you. I don't get no respect.
I don't get no respect, as he said.
I'll tell you.
When I was born, the doctor pulled me out by my blank. What? There it is.
Oh, there it is? Is this before the hospital?
That's
or...
right. I don't get no respect before...
No! Don't say that!
All right.
Uh-oh.
She just asked me if she can say no. Don't tell him. No.
It's my show. If she wants to tell me, she can tell me. What do you
think? Oh.
No.
Oh.
All right, I won't say it. All right. Wait a minute. I can't think
not
of
even
it.
Close.
No. Okay.
Well, how do they usually pull babies out?
Say it again.
It's usually by the hair, right?
Well, shh. We can't talk about it.
Okay, we won't discuss it. Okay.
No!
No! I can't say it. No.
Having a good time, Jamie?
Yeah, I'm the only one.
Yes.
I would have never done this before.
All right. We're going to start without you, Arsenio.
I'm ready, man.
All right. Rodney Dangerfield said, I don't get no respect. When I was born, the doctor pulled me out by my blank.
By my nose?
Nose. All right. Amy, I would say two of the stars should have said nose. Whether they did or not, we're going to find out. What do you say, Jamie? Pray tell.
I don't know how to play this game. You know, I said nose and I crossed it out.
Oh.
And I went to the other end.
Buns.
Yes.
All right. What do you got for us?
I was sitting here just looking at Jamie and I said nose.
Hey. What were you looking at?
I was looking at Jamie, too, and I said no.
Uh-huh. Don't
where were you looking?
I was trying to look at Jamie's reflection here in my water glass, but what happened was that my nose got in the way.
Uh-huh.
See?
I want
would imagine.
Linda, what did you finally end up with?
Well, I can't say what I really want. Anyway, I said neck.
You said neck.
Can't.
Right.
Can't.
No!
So the score at this moment is 4-3. Claudette's favor. Arsenio.
I'll tell you, I don't know. No, I feel like Stevie Wonder doing Rodney Dangerfield. I tell you. Okay, you know, actually, I like Jamie's nose, but I said nose for you, baby.
All right. 4-4. Hey, it's a good game we got going here. 4-4. Third and final round right after this.
One, eight, two.
Say it again.
One,
eight, two. One,
eight, two.
See, it's tied. You went first last time. That means, Amy, you'll go first this time.
I'll try A, please.
You want A? You sure?
Yeah.
That's this one right
okay.
here. Okay. Well, I guess you know that because you're a writer. Who plays? Jamie.
Naturally.
And Linda.
Naturally.
Only you two.
Oh,
all right.
Swell.
You ready?
Don't forget.
Right. Dumb Donald is so dumb. Before Tee-wee was invented. You did it to me. You did it to me.
No!
Actually, that was the answer to the last question.
Right.
No!
I understood that perfectly. Let me write my answer down.
No, I'm not finished yet.
Pulled him out
before
by his TV
was invented, yeah. Donald used to sit at home at night and watch his blink. You understand? You got it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, right. Right?
What? Put it down.
She wanted to know if she could say Pee-wee.
All right. Here we go. Amy, Dumb Donald's so dumb, before TV was invented, Donald used to sit at home at night and watch his blank.
His radio?
Radio is one possibility. Radio was one of the two good choices.
Yeah, I didn't say navel. I said radio.
Uh-huh. Show and tell time, Linda.
Yeah, this is the moment I wait for. Radio.
There it is. Now, Claudette. You could tie it. You can't win it. You could tie it by matching the two stars you have not matched, McLean and... Oh, wait a minute.
And someone.
Not me again, I hope.
McLean and who else? Heidi. Okay, McLean and Heidi.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Okay.
Hey, did you hear that Ronald McDonald got engaged? Yeah. Isn't that a lovely thought? He didn't give his girl a diamond ring. He gave her a blank ring. Ronald McDonald. McLean.
Yeah, I understand.
Oh, you sued her.
Just
all right.
Seeing what she wrote.
Cheating.
Oh. The thing is, they don't have these there.
Yeah. You're a bright man.
Don't write.
I think it's about time Ronald gets married. He served over $1 billion in that bedroom of his.
Here we go.
Okay.
Claudette, you ready?
Yes.
Ronald McDonald got engaged. He didn't give his girl a diamond ring. He gave her a blank ring.
An onion ring.
Onion ring. Okay. You're up.
I want to tell you something right now. What's the best possible answer? I thought of it myself.
And you rejected it?
No, because McDonald's don't sell onion rings. That's
they true. Don't?
No, sir.
They don't.
No.
That's right.
They got chicken McNuggets.
Yeah.
With your three sauces.
Yeah.
You got your Big Mac, your Little Mac, your cheeseburger,
so
your Big Mac with cheese. You got your Diet Pepsi, your root beer, your 2% low-fat milk, your cookies.
Yeah.
And this week we got a pail for the kid.
Right.
It's a blue pail. Next week, a yellow pail.
But no onion rings.
No onion rings at McDonald's.
I'm sorry. I'm going down the street to Wendy's.
I said Big Mac.
Big Mac. All sorry. Right, so that means Amy wins the game. What do you have? Heidi, what do you have? Come on down here, Amy. I thought it was good.
Now I know why you have the McCain's eating some dumb offs.
Claudette, thanks for being with us. We're going to send you some gifts. Claudette Lindsay. Hey there! Congratulations! Jason. How do you feel?
Great. Terrific.
Good. All right. Now we're going to switch over to Hollywood Squares and bring in the rest of the furniture and the stars. And John and I will trade places. Lots more excitement coming along. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive 28 diamond Benrus fashion watch, adjustable Italian mesh bracelet, silver tone dial and case, precision 17 jewel movement furnished by Benrus. It's time for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Square, our win from Night Court, Paula Kelly. From Scrabble, Jacques Woolery. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bowman.
All right, we'll be right back to play Hollywood Squares. Don't miss it.
And now, John Bowman and the Hollywood Square.
And here she is, Amy Lynch, who kind of hanged her opponent out to dry in the Match Game and is now zipping her way along to Hollywood Squares. Very good for you. Four noses and two radios, and you made it. Okay, we have three brand new celebrities with us. They are Paula Kelly.
Hi.
Arlene Francis. And Chuck Woolery. Ah, it's a wild crowd. And this wild crowd, I'm sure, will join me in welcoming one of the true veterans of really the entire television business and certainly the game show business. Arlene Francis is with us. Now, just to refresh our memories, how many years did you spend on What's My Line, Arlene?
25 years.
Wow.
When you said, oh, you think that's long?
Yes.
How long is that?
How long is that?
A quarter of a century.
Exactly.
That's a regular
Well, it is wonderful.
I'm actually a white-haired old woman.
You never know it.
It's wonderful to have you with us, and
Thank you.
You're looking lovely.
Thank
Why don't you and I zip over here and get started on Hollywood Squares, Amy Lynch. Here we go. Acquaint ourselves with our defending champion, whose name is Tamara Allison. Her total, hold on, this is the time to applaud. Her total in one day of play, $11,250. That is truly the time for a big hand. You have a 10-month-old son.
Right.
As I remember.
That's correct.
And I'm sure you can think of some things to do with $11,250. What's the first big expenditure you might make?
I need a new car, so good. We're real excited we're going to get a new one.
Okay, and also you write poetry, right?
Right.
Well, today you're going to play Hollywood Square once again with a new bunch of pros. And you will play it until you hear the time's up bell. Whoever is ahead at that point goes on to play Supermatch, which can be worth up to $30,000. You won $10,000 in your first crack at it. Let's see what happens today. First game's always worth $100, $25 for every square. Tamara, you are our champ. That means you get to pick a star and start us off.
Okay, McLean, please.
McLean Stevenson in the center square. Is the average 55-year-old man getting bald, or does he still have a full head of hair?
That's your average 55-year-old man.
Right.
As opposed to an abnormal 55-year-old man. Hit by a sign on Santa Monica Boulevard that said, wrestle a live nude lady.
Where? Where?
What fascinated me was not that she was nude, but that she was live. Can you imagine wrestling a dead nude lady?
Listen, anyway, before you sip off to Santa Monica Boulevard, McLean, can you answer this?
Just checking Jean's hair as I was thinking. I know. No, the average 55-year-old man is not bald.
Okay, has a full head of hair. Agree or disagree, Tamara?
I disagree.
The average 55-year-old man is getting bald. You were right to disagree, and you get the first square. Good play, right off the bat. Okay, Amy Lynch, she's on the board, but it's your move to pick a star for an O.
Jean, please.
Jean Rayburn.
Full head of hair.
I see. Why did the 1887 edition of the original White House cookbook recommend putting oil and black pepper in your ear? Was it to cure an earache or to stop your wife from snoring?
Oil and black pepper in your ear.
Can you just run that together in a sentence, Gene? Thanks.
I've heard it kinky, but this is ridiculous, Sam. Oil and black pepper in your ear, either to stop your wife from snoring...
Or to cure an earache.
You mean you put it in her ear?
No, you put it in your ear.
To stop her from snoring, I put it in my ear?
Well, if you don't like that one, pick the other one.
Pick another place, Gene. You don't like that.
Things were strange in 1887.
Oil and black pepper. Put it in my ear so my wife doesn't snore.
Why are you pointing at me?
I'm sorry. I don't snore. And what was the other one?
The other one was to cure an earache. Give me an answer.
I'd say cure an earache. They were dumb in those days.
Agree or disagree, Amy?
I'd agree.
It is to cure an earache. Yes, right, you agree, and you get the square. To season your ear, I think was the answer.
Yes.
Tamara, your move. Pick a star for an X.
Check, please.
Okay, Mr. Woolery, into the fray. New host of Scrabble.
Yes.
Host of a new
show. Soon, very soon.
According to the Book of Modern Table Manners, is it proper to pick your teeth with a toothpick at a picnic? Or should you only pick your teeth in private?
Is it proper to pick your teeth with a toothpick at a picnic? Say that three times fast. Or pick your teeth in private. Those are my two options.
Right.
I think in private, actually.
He says you should only pick your teeth in private. What do you say, Tamara?
I disagree.
You should only pick your teeth in private, according to the Book of Modern Table Manners, so you should have agreed with Mr. Woolery, and
trust me,
gets that square. It's a little too late. We will be back to complete our $100 game right after these messages. Stick with us.
Stay tuned for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
It's a tricky word to say, but a fun game to play.
You pronounce it.
$140.
It's weekdays at 4:30 on Buzzer. From the
now back to John Bauman on the Hollywood Square.
50 for the challenger, 25 for the champ. That means we're still in the middle of our $100 game, obviously. And Amy Lynch, your move for an O.
Paula, please.
Okay, Paula Kelly.
All right.
There is something unusual about the head of the graduating class at Annapolis Naval Academy this year.
Mm-hmm.
Is the top graduate Vietnamese, or is it a woman?
My two options are Vietnamese or a woman.
A woman.
Woman. Da, na, 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 na. Okay. I would say it is a woman.
Agree or disagree, Amy?
I'll agree.
The top graduate, the head of the graduating class at Annapolis, is a woman. You are right to agree. And you get a very pivotal square. Her name is Christine Holderreed, or Holdera. I don't know, I'm flunking out. But congratulations, Christine. Good. Yes. Tamara, not so good for you. Pick a star.
Arlene the Block, please.
Okay, you missed this one. The first game goes to Amy. Is there a school in New York City you have to attend to be a licensed cab driver? Or do cabbies have to learn everything on their own?
I certainly think I wish they had a school, so I have to think about that. I believe that they have to learn everything on their own, yes. Mm-hmm. From the way they drive, I think they do.
You think they haven't learned anything on their own, but they
I'm
have to
have
learn
a tough
everything
time
on
when
their
I get
own.
Back to New York, is all I can tell you.
Agree or disagree, Tamara, for a critical block?
I'll agree.
There is a school in New York City you have to attend. You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square, and your opponent wins the first game. Yeah, I surprised me, and I lived in New York my whole life. I'm very surprised. Taxi drivers have to go to school. I believe it's called a hackademy. Amy, you won the first game. Congratulations to you. But now we will sweep the X's and the O's off the board. We will move right on to a $200 game, which we will start with you, Tamara.
McLean, please.
McLean, once again. What lasts longer? An average rental tuxedo or an average emperor penguin?
A 55-year-old bald-headed man. A rented tuxedo probably lasts two proms, a bar mitzvah, a wedding, two funerals, and a dance. 6 months. I would say the tuxedo lasts longer.
What do you say, Tamara?
I disagree.
The penguin lasts longer. You are right to disagree, and you get the first square in the $200 game. And there's a big difference. An emperor penguin lasts on the average 25 to 30 years, which is pretty old, sounds to me, for a penguin. 1 year only for a rental tuxedo. Amy, your move.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Here we go.
Your dog drinks a cup of coffee every morning for 1 year.
That's why he looks so funny.
Will this improve his health, or will it kill him?
My dog is dying and he's laughing. I would say it would be very bad. You know, there's about 125 milligrams of caffeine in the average cup of coffee. And I think that intake in the dog's small body weight would be very damaging and could kill him in a year.
He says that'll kill him. Agree or disagree, Amy?
I'll agree.
It will kill him to drink a cup of coffee every morning for a year. It's interesting. It will actually kill him.
I swear to God.
Tamara, pick a star.
No. Arlene, please.
Arlene Francis.
Seriously.
Once again. According to Emily Post.
Knew her well.
Is it okay for a father to give his married daughter an allowance, or is that a serious breach of etiquette?
Should he give his married daughter an allowance, or is that a breach of etiquette?
Right.
Would he have to ask the husband if it was all right? No, it's not a breach of etiquette.
So it's okay?
It's okay. I mean, if it was my father-in-law, I'd say certainly.
Is it okay for a father to give his married daughter an allowance? What do you say, Tamara?
I disagree.
It is okay, according to Emily Post. No, you should have agreed with Arlene. It is okay.
I'm so
you hear
sorry.
That, dad-in-law? We will be back to complete our $200 game after this. Join us.
Never have so many shows been so primed for primetime. Buzzer Prime, weeknights starting at 8.
Oh, I love that.
Right here on Buzzer.
$250 for the challenger and $50 for the champ. But if you've been watching our show for a while, you realize that that is hardly an insurmountable lead in a $200 game. Amy, it is your move, however.
Paula, please.
Paula Kelly from Night Court. The first time Smokey the Bear appeared in public, did he wear blue jeans, or was he bare all over?
The first time?
The first time.
Ever we saw his face.
Right.
Or his... He wore, did you say blue jeans?
I said blue jeans.
He was bare all over.
Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
He wore blue jeans. You should... No. He wore blue jeans. Your opponent gets that square. He wore blue jeans. I have a great footnote here. He wore blue jeans and a hat.
Actually, I thought he wore overalls. Mm. Didn't he?
Tamara, that was a bit of a break for you. Pick a star.
Arsenio to win, please.
And this is how quickly things can change, because this would give you the game and the lead. Arsenio Hall, it's 1919. Are there car radios, or do you have to hum?
Ooh, 1919. There were definitely not car radios in cars.
What do you say for the game?
I agree.
You have to hum. You were right to agree. You get the square, you win the game, and you take the lead. No soap car radios, not a 1919. Good for you, Tamara Allison. You're doing okay, but take the X's and O's off of the board. Let's move right on to a $300 game because we are in our final segment of Hollywood Squares, and let's speed it up, and we're going to start with you, Amy.
McLean, please.
Okay, Mr. Stevenson. You're a cockroach.
Same to you, fella.
And the people whose house you were infesting have moved out, leaving nothing but old toenail clippings.
Oh, yeah.
Can you eat them, or will you go hungry?
You have your rights. You don't have to answer.
No, in the interest of time and gross.
Put yourself in a cockroach.
You can eat toenail clippings.
Can.
Yes, a cockroach can eat toenail clippings.
A cockroach can eat toenail clippings. What do you say, Amy?
I'll agree.
Cockroaches can eat toenail clippings.
That's why they're called cockroaches.
Oh, McLean, you know your stuff. Right. That's why they've been around for hundreds of millions of years. Tamara, your move.
Paula, please.
Okay, Paula Kelly.
Okay.
What weighs more, a pint of heavy cream or a pint of light cream?
Well, it would seem that a pint of heavy cream would weigh more.
What do you say, Tamara?
I agree.
A pint of heavy cream weighs more. Yes, you're right to agree, and you get this. That's one of those questions that's there to keep you guys honest. Yes, just what you might think. Heavy cream weighs more. Amy Lynch, pick a star for an O.
Chuck, please.
Chuck Woolery. When a cat eats a canary, are the feathers a taste sensation, or does he only eat feathers by accident?
Oh, I think they like to play with the feathers. It's probably a taste sensation and a playful sensation.
Okay, so it is a taste sensation. They like the feathers.
I think so.
Agree or disagree, Amy?
I disagree.
A cat only eats canary feathers by accident. Good for you. You're right to disagree, and you get the square. Good. You look like the cat who just ate the canary because you got a couple O's up there. Tamara, you got one X. Make your move.
Gene the Block, please.
All right. Now you miss this one, then the game and the lead goes back to Amy. From the Arctic, scientists have brought back pieces of 10,000-year-old ice.
Of course.
Is this ice the purest edible substance on Earth? Or is it as deadly as cobra venom?
I say it's very pure because there were no cars 10,000 years ago. Very pure.
He says it's the purest edible substance on Earth for a very critical block. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
It is the purest edible substance on Earth, and you are right to agree. You get the square and you do block. Which means that the tables have now turned. They have truly turned. Time is up. She has done it once again. Tamara Allison is our champ. Second day in a row. That was kind of a thriller. Came down dramatically to the final question. The purest edible substance on Earth was that block of ice, and one of the purest feelings is the feeling of victory. Sit right over there, join Gene, get set for your shot at the big money once again. And I'm afraid we're gonna have to say goodbye to a very good player.
Thank you.
He gave her a real good run for her money, Amy Lynch. You're leaving here with $300 and our thanks for playing Match Game Holly.
Thank you, I had a great time.
Okay, Gene.
Now, here we are with the champ. She knows what she has to do, and we'll be back with her to do it right after this.
One, eight, two.
Say it again.
One,
eight, two.
One,
eight, two.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you. Here we go. Ready?
Ready.
She's really excited about this. She's got a feeling she's going to win the big one today, right?
Oh, I hope so.
I hope so, too. Good luck to you. Here we go with a super match. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank Shepherd. If you give us the answer they chose most often, it's $1,000. For the next one, $500. And $250 for the third. Any three of the nine stars are allowed to offer a little assistance here. Whom do you call on?
John.
German.
German Shepherd.
McLean.
Good.
Good Shepherd. Do you have two now?
Check.
Ooh, I was going to say German Shepherd, too. Wow, let me think. German
third
Shepherd.
Third is a tough position, Shepherd. Chuck.
I beg your pardon?
But you can do it.
What?
I say
yes.
Third is tough.
Hello.
Yeah.
How about the Lord is my?
That's not bad. Good. Steal that one from Arlene.
The Lord is my. Yeah, Sam Shepherd would be good, yeah.
Sam Shepherd.
Or Sybil.
What
Shepherd.
Do you want?
Sybil Shepherd. I think that's better.
Sybil Shepherd.
Yes.
Okay. So you have Sybil Shepherd, Good Shepherd, and German Shepherd. You want to choose one of those, or would you like to create one of your own?
I'll go with German.
German Shepherd. All right. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Audience thinks that you're right in that decision. Let's see how right you are. May we see the $250 response, please? The Lord is.
Oh, my gosh.
Very good, Arlene.
That's great.
Right
she ain't been doing game shows this long.
Nothing.
Lady right. No, really.
All right. The $500 response says, Alan Shepard.
Alan Shepard.
He was the astronaut.
Yes, sure.
Right.
It's got to be Jim.
And the $1,000 response says, Jerna.
Sure.
Very good.
All right.
Chip.
All right. Now, Tamara, you're going to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you've made your decision, we'll ask that star to reveal the hidden number, and we'll multiply your $1,000 by whatever number is revealed. Time now to choose a star.
John.
Okay, John, we want to see whether you've got a 10, a 20, or the 130 that's up there. A 10, so you're playing for $10,000. Okay. $10,000. Ready. Here we go. Draft blank. That's D-R-A-F-T blank. Draft blank.
Let's see.
This is such a...
Is the committee finished? Okay. Now, you collected $10,000. Again, you did it once before, simply by matching John. What do you say? Draft blank.
Registration?
The audience is groaning. As a matter of fact, they're walking out of the building. Draft registration seems unlikely to me, but we'll find out. John might have said it.
Well, you know, we hit one of those questions where there are so many answers. Draft beer, draft card. I said draft board.
Draft board, yeah. All right, well, you were both thinking
they're all
of
kind of good,
that
yeah.
kind of drafting process. You've improved your position considerably here with the 1,000 and what you won in the Hollywood Squares part. You now have a total of $12,600. Congratulations. We'll be back with the champ and the stars right after this. Now we want to find out where the large number was. Somewhere up there is 130 number. All right, stars, let's reveal it right now. Ready, set, go. Who has it?
Linda.
Linda Mano had it.
Only there. One seat open. She would have said registration, right?
That's right. It's the first thing I thought of, you see?
All right, stars, we'll see you manana, and we'll see you tomorrow. Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Bobbitt saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive Duquesne's Gas Grill with a colorful cabinet, American-made, featuring three burners, two for grilling, one for rotissing, and a steel cooking grid designed to hold heat more efficiently, furnished by Duquesne. For the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.